Jam time. Stop. All right, now what you just saw is I use Siri on my iPhone, and you could use an iPad, to trigger Google Assistant automation. Now that means I can utilize any of these Google Home or a Google Assistant related automation. And of course I can go ahead, get the news, the weather, whatever I wanna do with my Google Assistant. So let me show you how to do that in your home or even on the road just with your iPhone. Now the first thing to do, and I already set this up, so I'm gonna have to just run it on the screen here on my phone, but you know, you basically, the first time you go into the Google Assistant application, when it's been updated to the appropriate version on your iPhone, you will see the function of clicking Add to Siri. And once you add it to Siri, once you go through that little process, you have the ability now within Shortcuts, which is an iOS 12 and greater basically functionality here that allows you to trigger automation. Once you've added the Google Assistant to Siri, there's a couple things I want you to check. So I'm going to go into my iPhone settings here, and I'm going to scroll down to the actual Assistant application within the settings here. Now, you can see I'm allowing location to be used and all these other things, but Siri and search is where I want you to go into here. So once inside of there, you see the Siri and suggestions there, and there's also the shortcuts showing up because I've already set up one here, or I've already set up actually a number of these. Now, once you've used Google Assistant, what starts to happen is these recent shortcuts start to show up, and this means that they show up as suggestions when you're going to set up a new shortcut. I'll show you what that means in a second here, but you want to make sure that that Siri and suggestions is checked on or turned on here, and that's just the easiest way to go through creating shortcuts with your Google Assistant. Now, once you've done that, we can go into the Google Assistant application. So you're going to need that. You're going to need it signed into the same account that you're using for all of your home automation if you want to use this at home. So you make sure your Google Home app is signed into the same as your Google Assistant app when you do this. Now, the other thing you're going to do is actually use the Google Assistant. So you give it whatever command you'd like to teach. So what I did is I said basically play music on my basement office display. That's what this device is called in the Google Home application. So once I said that, it showed up as a shortcut in the Siri and suggestions there, and also in that settings page that I just showed you. All right, so what I'm going to do next is actually teach Siri a command through the Google Assistant. Now, I'm going to start a YouTube video that you should be pretty familiar with here on my basement living room display. This is a Google Home Hub. So I'm just going to tap the microphone here. Play Automate Your Life on YouTube on Basement Living Room.
Okay, playing Automate Your Life from YouTube on Basement Living Room.
Hello everyone, thanks. So there you go. I started and I stopped. Now, what I've done is I've created a Siri suggestion to go ahead and use. So let me show you how to use that next. So now switching over to Shortcuts here. Now, Shortcuts is the application. If you don't already have it, you can download it on the App Store, but it should be on any iOS device 12.0 and greater basically. Now you can see my jam time shortcut that I created earlier in the video. You saw that run actually just random music here. That's the command I had set up, but we're going to create a brand new shortcut. So top right, I'm hitting the plus here, and now that I'm in here, I go to the search bar and I can go to Siri suggestions, and you can see all the different Google Assistant ones that I've recently done. So I want to play Automate Your Life on YouTube on Basement Living Room Display. So that's the one I want to use, and you can see I have an untitled shortcut, and if I hit that little play button, it will run this shortcut and right away start that on my basement living room, my Google Home Hub. Now, there's a couple of things to do to move forward here and make sure that Siri works seamlessly for you, because you don't want to be saying that every time. And that's one of the nice features here of Shortcuts. So the first thing I'm going to do is hit the little switches here, and I can rename it up at the top. So I'm going to call this one myself. Now, I can change the icon, of course, if you wanted to go and pick something else, you could. I don't really care for now, but Add to Siri is the important piece here. So we're going to tap that, and now it wants me to record a sound, or a sound bite basically, that basically makes this shortcut trigger in iOS. Now, it allows you to say anything you'd like here. You could set anything really, but keep in mind, if you're using some of those basic commands that Siri is going to use all the time, like show me the weather, you know, Siri might interpret that as actually show me the weather, which is embedded inside of Siri these days. So you have to think a little bit outside of the box. And so I'm going to use something a little bit different here. Show me. So now I could re-record that phrase if I didn't like how that turned out, but I'm going to hit done. And now it's added to Siri. And anytime I say show me to Siri now, it's going to run that little basically script essentially now, and it's going to bring in the Google Assistant and run that. So let's go ahead now and do a demo. So now that I've gone ahead and I've created that phrase, obviously if I wanted, I could do a number of other things here. I'm not gonna run through adding it to the home screen so you can trigger that with a button. That's obviously something that you can do though. You can share the shortcut so you could send this to your family if they couldn't figure out how to do this. But in general, we're done here and we can go ahead and run this with Siri, or we can do it inside the Shortcuts application. So you can see now I have this applet here, this shortcut down at the bottom of the Shortcuts application. So if I just tap on that, it will run it and bring it up, but that's not the point here. I want to show you how to use Siri to do this. So now let's go ahead, and I'm just going to hold the button here, start Siri up, and then we're going to go ahead and use the Google Assistant through Siri. Show me. Now, if you're watching the screen, you can actually see it rolling through the different portions of the Google Assistant, and you can see that command went in, that full command, and now we're playing the video on YouTube here on all through Siri, all through iOS Shortcuts. So, stop. So there you go. I think that's a pretty good demo. Now, obviously, you can take this a lot further. You have devices that are connected to HomeKit. You have devices that are, you know, connected to Google Home that aren't connected to HomeKit. And now, if you want, through a shortcut, you can use a HomeKit device, trigger a scene, and then you can use Google Assistant. So you can actually tie together now HomeKit and your Google Home, and I'll be showing that as we go forward here on Automate Your Life. Obviously, I'm not gonna show you everything today, but I think this gives you a good basis for moving forward with your Google Assistant. If you're on the road, you can use that as well. And your Google Home suite of products in your home, along with your iPhone. And it basically, this functionality catches those of us with an iPhone up to those people with an Android device who have Google Assistant embedded. This allows you to catch up with just a little bit of extra setup. All right, guys, there you go. Now, you tell me what you think about this new functionality from Google using Apple's system of shortcuts there. That's all I'm gonna show you today. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.